Mr. Ken has been another father figure to me, pretty much. Morals, values, anything that you would say that, you know, a father would instill into their child. Just anything good, always the best things. And like I said, I loved how he just kept it real. He didn't sugarcoat anything. He just always told me the truth regardless of...
How did that help you tell you the truth? You could kind of trust him.
That and the trust factor is very important, especially when you're dealing with someone that, you know, is working you out. And it's either if you don't trust the person that's training you, then mentally, you're not going to go, and physically, you're not going to go but so far. So it was very important for me to trust Mr. Kennedy. Yeah.
And you always thought that he was doing what he believed was the best for you.
Definitely.
What a great thing.
Never questioned that.
Just felt like we were sort of the ultimate team, and really we were working together to be this, you know, this ultimate thing. That to really achieve what the goals we set out to achieve. And you know, another thing is at the beginning, maybe not quite as early as our first meeting, but pretty quickly on, Sir Kenny started sort of prophesizing these times that I would hit, which sounded most ridiculous. Sort of, you know, hitting 23 in the 200, under 12 in the 100. She's like, this is insane, you know. He's like, you're gonna hit this in a year. She's like, no, there's no way. You know, I'm running 14 right now. I'm running 28s, and sure enough, within 6 months, a year, I was hitting these times, and we're just, you know, blown away that he could see this and that we were, you know, we were getting there, and it really felt like it was just this teamwork. We're both like just working together to and achieving these milestones that he was, you know, putting in front of us.
Dedication, from what you were saying, dedication. Mr. Kenny is very dedicated. Like he said, it was times this year where it was raining. I was like, I texted Mr. Kenny, do we have practice? Like, he'll be like, yeah, we have practice. Is it thundering?
Did you not learn that years ago?
I forgot, because I've been away for 9 years, so I really forgot. And he was like, yeah, we do have practice. So he's very dedicated. And I'm not going to say that my college coaches was not dedicated.
Right.
But I knew, like, when it was time, like 6 o'clock, they were ready to go to their families. Not saying that Mr. Kenny didn't have a family, but sometimes that extra 5 minutes, 10 minutes is, you know, can be very important to an athlete. Definitely. Not just, oh, them, as soon as there's a time coming up and they're just ready to pack up and go. No, we have eyes. We see that. So dedication, he's very dedicated, and I think that's very important in a coach.
The biggest thing for me is that, you know, when I find I have a group of kids that really are taking to what I'm trying to do, then, you know, if they're willing to run through the fire, and that's what I call it, then guess what?
Feels like it.
I have to do what I have to do as far as a coach to, you know, make them or to try to get them even better. You know, they're talking about the good things. They were bad. Trust me, both of them, I can tell you, you know, many a times, right? Many a times, you know, they probably had some choice words within themselves for me or outwardly too. You know, everybody's different. You know, everything wasn't, you know, a bowl of cherries and roses all the time.
Right.
But, you know, deep down inside, I knew that they always had the love for what they were doing.
Mm-hmm.
And they wanted to, the biggest thing for me is they always want to learn. And when I say learn, you know, when you're running track, to get better, you have to learn how to get better. When I find that I have people who are willing to learn, you know, sometimes, hey, we all have bad days.
Yeah.
You know, you have a bad day. But if you're willing to learn, you will always progress yourself, not only just in track, but in life. And, you know, and even kids that, because I'm kind of, I can be a little, excuse me, a little anal about it sometimes, but, you know, I'm going to stay on you.
Mm-hmm.
If I think you have potential,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to try to bring that potential out of you.
Mm-hmm.
Whether sometimes you like it or you don't like it. And, you know, ultimately, you know, if you can do what I need you to do and run up to your potential or better, you know, you're going to benefit from it. And that's the goal, you know, and not just for now, but later on in life, because, you know, these experiences carry on, you know, for your life forever.